Hello, everyone. All right, so I want to talk clean beauty products with you guys tonight. So what is it and why is it even important for you? Well, if you think about how many different products you are putting on your skin or your body every single day, you would be shocked to hear what is inside of some of those. So I'm not talking about just beauty products, meaning, you know, just like hair and makeup. I'm talking about like your body wash, your body lotion, your sunscreen, bug spray, hair products, makeup, nail polish, all of that stuff. Everything you're putting on your body is just as important as what you're putting in your body. So you would be surprised to hear that there are quite a few ingredients that are actually carcinogenics, endocrine disruptors, or skin irritants or allergens. So it's no wonder that so many people have like hormonal imbalance, or, you know, it could also result in not being able to get pregnant. Well, these different chemicals that we're putting in are soaking into our skin and they are disrupting our hormonal system. So it's super scary. There are certain products like sodium lauryl sulfate, sodium laureth sulfate. They are known skin irritants. They're usually listed as one of the top five in a lot of products. The really bad thing is through their processing and when they're being processed, sometimes they can be I almost want to say like infected with this chemical. It's 1,4-dioxide, which is a known carcinogenic. So it's something that happens through the processing that this can leak into that ingredient. So it's best to stay away from these things. And the scary thing is that because it's near the top of the list, there's more of it in there. So when you look at your ingredient label, if you're looking at something near the top, all the way down, kind of list it in order of like potency or how much is in there. That's why more than likely you usually see water as one of the number one ingredients. So super scary. A lot of what we're putting in there can actually be causing a lot of damage to us. I didn't even realize when I was putting, you know, using the different body washes for my kids, like my daughter's back would have all these dry patches. And I was like, I don't know if it's like the laundry detergent or like what it could be. But I truly think it was probably the body wash, because there's a lot of skin irritation in there and things that can dry out the skin, which is what was happening to her back. So with just a short time of switching, like her back is already getting better. And I also didn't even realize like some of these chemicals are like synthetic, like food coloring, which does not need to be in our body products at all. But one of the body washes had Red 40, which is super harmful. So it kind of is good to be your own advocate to understand what is in your products for what you and your family are putting on your body. So we have to be our own advocate, because they have not done any regulation to the beauty industry, like really done any regulation, since like 1938. That is super scary. So I know things like back in like 2018, they started trying to talk about like, we should start regulating things because people are actually getting a lot of bad reactions to a lot of these ingredients, but things have not changed yet. So that's where you need to understand what is in your products. So if you would like, I have actually something for you. It is the top 10 harmful ingredients in your beauty products. I will put the link below. You can sign up for that. You get a PDF that says what those ingredients are and what they're harmful for. You also get a little print off. It's a business card size you can put in your wallet, so you have it on hand when you go to the store. And they also made it available, so if you want to put it on like the wallpaper of your phone if you're out and about shopping. There's also a couple other things that you could do, because the main thing is just knowing what's in there so that way you can make the healthiest decision for you guys. So I actually just wrote a blog post on this. So you will be getting this in your inbox if you are subscribed tomorrow, Friday. If you are not subscribed yet, just please, you can put list down in the comments and I'll be in touch with you. So that way you can get those blog posts as they come out weekly. But I'm sharing with you my top three tips to make it a little bit easier when you're wanting to switch to healthier products. Tip number one, I want you to download the Think Dirty app or the Healthy Living app. You can also look up the website is ewg.org. Those apps are great. So you can scan the back of your product and it will rate it for you, a 0 to a 10, 0 being safe, 10 being harmful. And it'll scan it and it'll tell you what ingredients in there are harmful and whatnot. It actually rates each ingredient. So those are really good bases or like a foundation to start at. However, not every product is in there. And also they don't always have the most up-to-date. If the company reformulates, they don't always have the most up-to-date. So that's why that's a good base to start with. But I want you to be your own advocate in understanding the certain chemicals that you want to look out for. And you'll start, once you start learning about it, you'll start being able to recognize those just like this. So, because there's also some chemicals that have these huge long names that you would think they've got to be harmful, right? And they actually are pretty safe. Okay, so tip number two, break it down by category. So when you want to start making this overhaul, it's easier if you can do it in bite-sized pieces. So break it down, like your body care, your hair care, skin care, makeup, nail care. Take it one at a time so it's not so overwhelming. My last and final tip, tip number three, is do some of your research at home. There is nothing worse than having decision fatigue or buyer's fatigue when you walk into the store and you see all of these options ahead of you and you don't even know where to begin. So I would say do a little bit of research ahead of time. You can get a couple ideas of things that you want to look at. Scan your app, look at your little print off that you signed up for me, and you can make those decisions. But I like to know what I'm looking for before I go, or actually even a few different options of a couple different companies. Those are good ways to start. You can also learn more about some of these ingredients in my private group called Clean Beauty Babes. I post different ingredients. I'll talk about different products in there that are less harmful. And I would love to have you there. So if you guys have any questions at all when it comes to clean beauty and how it impacts you and why you need to be your own advocate for this, please do not hesitate to reach out. I am so happy to answer the questions for you guys. Otherwise, I hope you have a lovely evening. Don't forget to sign up below to get your own copy of the harmful ingredients, and I will see you later.